Hello, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Crash Landing. Oh, yeah. So last episode, we set up this crazy mob trap contraption thing, and it's working pretty well. We're getting mobs spawning all over the place. You can see them on the mini-map everywhere inside that general area. We do have a problem with spiders. There's a certain type of spiders from special mobs called ghost spiders, and those guys can go through blocks. So, yeah, that's kind of a thing. Or we can't really AFK over here. We gotta be away. Now, another problem is... Oh, yeah, look at that. We got little baby spiders that can spawn in there, too. Yeah, another problem with this mob tower is when you're far enough away, mobs stop moving. They don't wander around aimlessly. So we need to get away for the mobs to... Or that spawn up here to get over onto the conveyor belts and fall down the drop tube. A way we can do that is by using extra utilities. There's an item called a fan. There we go. This fan. Yeah, this fan. No, there's a fan, and that's what the recipe is for it. So it's an iron bar, iron, and some kind of a stone slab of some description. So yeah, not too bad. So I think we're going to end up building a few of those and putting them along the outside. So any mobs that spawn in here should get pushed towards the edges. The fans do work through blocks, and they also work, like if you stack two, like if you put a fan here and a fan here blowing this way, they stack. So it's like twice the blowing power or whatever. So yeah, I think that's what we're going to end up doing up here at some point in the future once we get a little bit more iron. But for now, I think we're all set. Another thing, we're now collecting ender pearls at a decent rate. Yeah, those mobs keep glitching through. It's a little freaky. Yeah, we're collecting ender pearls at a decent rate. Look at that. We already got a stack. That's not bad. So I'm going to take some of those ender pearls. And what I want to do is make a vacuum hopper. That's a really, really awesome item. It'll grab items from a, I think it's like a 3x3 around it or something. But yeah, it'll grab items and suck it into itself, and then it'll act like a hopper from there. So you need a hopper, you need a piece of obsidian, which I don't think we have. We don't. Do I have a bucket of water on me? I do. Okay, so let's go make ourselves some obsidian. Let's go ahead and grab this. We'll stick that there. Grab some lava, stone barrel, water. There we go, a little obsidian. Perfect. Okay, so now we got some obsidian. We got a hopper. I think there's one more piece to this thing. What is it? Vacuum hopper. Ah, the ender pearl, of course. Okay, so now we'll have all three pieces that we need to make the vacuum hopper. That'll be great. So let's go ahead and do that. Hopper, ender pearl. Boom. Awesome. So the reason why I wanted one of these, actually, let's see, I think... I want to build like a big chest. How do you make a diamond chest? Can you just make that? Or do you have to... You have to make a silver chest with some diamonds or a gold chest. Okay, so how do you make the gold chest? You have to do a silver chest. There's no real easy, quick way, is there, to make this thing. I wanted to just make it with one recipe. What about the silver chest thing? Yeah, copper and silver. Blah. Okay, so I think we're going to make ourselves a regular chest. We'll turn that into an iron chest. We'll turn that into a gold chest. And I think from there, we'll upgrade it if needed or if necessary is what I was going to say. And then I think we wrapped that in gold, right? Yeah, so there's a gold chest. Perfect. Okay, so what I want to do is I want to start sieving this gravel that we have over here. So let's go ahead and grab our four autonomous activators. Oh, I do have a few more hoppers in here. Perfect. Crucible, a deep tank controller. Apparently I've been using this just for random things. A dolly is a great item from Jabba that I made. This thing allows you to pick up barrels and move them wherever, but while you have them picked up, you do get like a slowness effect. So let's see. We do want to set up this autonomous activator thing. And where do we want it? I think right here should be fine. So I think we'll put one here and there. Let's go ahead and fix this guy. We don't want to point it straight up. So do that. Yep. I do need to go grab our sieve. So right in here. Perfect. Yeah, this is going to let us get so many ores. We'll be getting diamonds and emeralds and all that stuff. It'll be great. Okay, so now that is set up the way I want it to be, let's go and break this thing. So now we need to get the gravel into all of these guys. Now, how are we going to do that? We might just end up using the item ducts that we have gotten. Yeah, we might have to do that. Let's sleep real quick. I'm going to have to move this bed to a better spot. I really should make just more than one bed, so I just have them everywhere. If I need to sleep, I can just sleep. Okay. Yeah, I think I did make a few more item ducts last episode when we were setting up the barrels and stuff for the mob trap over there. I think we'll end up doing that. It's not the cleanest solution, but it will work. Oh, no, they're over here, I believe. Item duct. We will need a lever. I think I stuck it in this chest. I did. Okay. Yeah, the only thing we need to do is fill up these autonomous activators full of gravel. I guess we could do it manually. We don't really need to do this all automatically, but, you know, we might as well. Let's dig out a little bit underneath this thing just so we can see what we're doing a little bit better. All right, get a stair out of here. And fill those in. Okay, perfect. So yeah, we have these item ducts, so we can go ahead and place those guys right like that, and we'll need them connected. I guess we'll connect them right in the center. That should be fine. And as far as the barrel of gravel, where do we want to set that? I'm not sure. Maybe we could set it right here. Right between these guys so we can see from a distance how much more gravel we have. Perfect. Let's go ahead and do that. We'll take the dolly. Stick it right there. Okay, so then we also need to change this arrow to be pointed down. Okay, so before we go any further than this, I do want to get the vacuum hopper set up. So let's get that going. So we'll put the vacuum hopper here. This will pick up any item around it. Just go right into the vacuum hopper. These things are great. And then we'll have that going into, I guess, this gold chest. We'll just stick it right next to it. Not there. Give me that back. All right, let's just do it this way. Okay, so I do need to right-click this thing and then set the item output to point into the chest. Yes, I think that is pretty much all we need to do at this point. So one final thing is I need to put a lever right here and turn that on, and this thing should just start working as soon as gravel goes into these other things. Is this pulling out? Does not appear to be pulling out, does it? Why is that not working? Those are item ducts that should be pulling out. Or does it have to have a servo in there to pull out? Oh, you know, it might have to have a servo. Let's go ahead and take this off for now. I thought the servo was only to make it have the redstone without the lever. I might have done something else incorrect here. I'm not sure. Let's try this. Let's just do ignore. So that turns it on. And nothing is happening. Okay, so maybe you can't pull out of the bottom of these barrels with an item duct. Or maybe I have done... Oh, I know what it is. Oh, I'm such a derp. Okay, let's go ahead and get that servo back. I am a derp. Of course it doesn't want to go into any of the autonomous activators. We haven't configured them to accept items from the bottom. So let's go ahead and do that. We want blue on the bottom. Blue. Yeah, I'm going to have to eat some food. I'm starving, apparently. And blue. Okay. So now, if we put a lever here, now it should start pulling items out. There it goes. Yeah, now it's pulling items out. It's going into one of these. There it is. Now we're automatically sieving. And those are being put into the chest. Awesome. Okay, so let's get some food before we die. We don't want to die. Guess we'll eat some bread. Yes, this is great. So now the only thing we need to do is get a way to automatically make gravel and have it put into that barrel right there. In fact, I might even move this barrel to the other side and then have our automatic smashing thing right here or something. I don't know. We'll figure it out. But yeah, guys, so we got this set up. We'll just go ahead and, I guess, fill this all in underneath, make it nice and pretty. There we go. And dust and dust. Perfect. So now you can't even tell there's anything underneath it going on. But yeah, we are automatically sieving all of our dust or all of our gravel. And we're collecting ores automatically. So that is great. Yeah, we can also set these up for sand and dust. Just have to make some more autonomous activators. Set up a few more of these stations and we'll collect all of the materials automatically without any more intervention. So that is great. Okay, so now that that is done, I think it's time. Do I want to set up those fans up there yet? Probably not. It kind of felt like our dynamo that we made that's powering the grinder over there just doesn't provide enough power for the grinder, like it's running out of power. We might have to make another dynamo or two for that over there before we start sending more mobs down. I don't know. We'll figure that out later. So let's see. Let's take a look at the book real quick. Let's see what we need to do. So basic survival, I think. Yeah, this is all done except for killing a few more Endermen. I have to kill 9 more of those things. I'll probably do that off camera at some time. Under pressure, yeah, this is something else we need to do is to make these empty PCBs. We have been using items that we've looted from the city. We have 1 unassembled PCB left at this point. Once we use this for another machine frame or whatever, we're going to be stuck. So I think it'll be a very good idea to figure out how to make more of those. And it looks like this is how you do it. So this says, now that we've gotten this far, we can get started on laying the foundation for pretty much all technological progression, the PCB. To start, you simply need to toss a compressed iron and piece of green plastic in the pressure chamber. Simple. Now, I've actually already done that. Did I not? Oh, maybe I left them over here at the pressure chamber. Yeah, I made 10 of these things. So we put the green creeper plant seeds in there, turn it into the green plastic, and then put those in with the compressed iron. And then we get these PCBs. So I guess we can manually detect that one. Okay, so, let's see. A task where the player needs to hand in a specific item, sure. So step 2. Next up, toss the empty PCB into a UV light box, and you simply have to wait. While you can pull the PCB out before it's fully processed, there is a chance it will fail the last step, the etching. If you don't like the long wait, you may wish to install a few speed upgrades in the light box. Okay, so speed upgrade, no, speed. Let's just search for speed. All right, right. Okay, didn't we already get like 2 of these? Somewhere, maybe they're over here in these other chests. Aha, so we got 2 of those. Okay, so we have to make ourselves a light box. And it didn't tell us how to make one of those. Is that the other quest over here? No. Okay, so how do we make a light box? UV light box. Aha. So 3 redstone lamps, a pressure tube, a PCB blueprint, and some compressed iron. Okay. Oh, wow. All right. So we need 8 emeralds. How many do we have? Oh, we have 8. Perfect. what else do we need? And around a piece of compressed iron. So let's go ahead and make that real quick. We'll go ahead and get rid of all of our emeralds. Bear in mind that this crafting recipe is temporary. Once I give mechanics, pneumatic craft villagers, a place to live, I will remove this crafting recipe and you'll only be able to obtain this item via trading. Abuse it while you can. All right. So we need the pressure tube. I can't remember if we have any extras. I imagine we should have extra pressure tubes around here somewhere. I'm not seeing any in there. None in there. And this chest, yes, pressure tube. So redstone lamps, let's go ahead and do that. So we need 12, and I think it's 12 of these too, right? Might be. It's been a while since I've made a redstone lamp. Okay, so that's that, and I think it's just split these guys up. All right, perfect. And We need 4 compressed iron. Okay, so there's that. There's that. This. And that. UV light box. Awesome. Okay, so how does this thing work? It said all we had to do is toss those into this thing. It requires pressure. Of course it does. Upgrades. Let's go ahead and grab one of my other camel packs to stop us from sweating all over the place. That's disgusting. Okay, so this requires pressure. Let's go and stick it over here by our pressure stuff. Apparently I've done that incorrectly. How about if we stick it? Oh, there we go. Now it connects. Okay. So now we got pressure. Yep. Perfect. All right. So let's stick one of these guys in there. And I think that's... Oh, these don't stack anymore. Wait. What? Oh, that says 8. Okay. Yeah, let's go ahead and put these upgrades in there. Is this doing anything? Problems? No problems. Pressure? I guess it is losing air, so it must be doing something. Oh, yeah, here we go. All right, so it's doing stuff. Looks like it's turning nighttime. Let's go ahead and sleep. I'm going to go ahead and create a few of those things, and we'll be right back, guys. All right, guys. Well, we got one of these empty PCBs done to 100% chance of success. We're waiting on more of these to complete. So while that's going on, I've decided to come over here and start collecting a little bit of sand. So we can sieve that, hopefully try and get some ancient spores. Basically, what I want to do is be able to get nether wart, which you have to make soul sand from. And you get soul sand by having mycelium. Mycelium makes witch water. You put sand in witch water, makes soul sand. You sieve soul sand, you get a chance to make a nether wart. It's a real complicated thing. But the first step is to sieving sand. I think a piece went in here. Yes. Sieve the sand, try and get the ancient spore so you can make mycelium, so you can make witch water, so you can make soul sand. Okay, so yeah, while we're waiting on those other things to process, I'm just sitting here and sieving my own stuff, hopefully trying to get those ancient spores. So let me go ahead and do this a little bit longer and make a few more of those empty PCBs, and we'll be right back, guys. Okay, guys, so as it turns out, that whole stack of these PCBs, I could put in the light box at the same time. So I could have done all of these with one process. I'm not sure if that's an intended thing or unintended, since these things don't actually stack and neither do the other ones, but they come out of the pressure chamber stacked. So yeah, well, we went ahead and did that. We don't, 7 of these only cost the amount as it does for one. So the next step is we need to sleep, but I'm pretty sure it said that we need to throw those into some kind of an acid or something. So let's take a look at the quest book once again, figure out what this thing has to say. So we're done on that step 2. You have to do the etching. Okay, so we're going to get some capacitors, transistor, and a compressed iron. Oh, maybe it didn't say that. Okay, so etching. Yeah, etching acid bucket. Okay, so it says, so now you have an empty PCB. What do you do with it? Simple, you drop it in a hole and pour etching acid over it. It takes 5 minutes to process, though. So you are going to want to pick it up a few times, both to check on the process and to make sure it doesn't despawn. Okay. If you think the whole process is overly complex and tedious, there is an alternative. That said, your first few PCBs will need to be made by hand, so to speak. Okay, so that'll give us a printed circuit board, some plastic sheets. We have to make an etching acid bucket, and we have to manually detect that. So etching acid bucket. So in order to do that, we need gunpowder, rotten flesh, spider eyes, and plastic, and a water bucket, and the pressure chamber. Okay, that doesn't sound too difficult. So let's go ahead and grab these. We should have all the pieces here. So I think it said rotten flesh, spider eyes, gunpowder. Was that it? Yep, and 2 creeper plant seed plastics. All right, and then a water bucket. So we have all of that stuff. The next thing we need to do, oh, you know what? I did break that. Let's go ahead and fix that as well. So item duct in my pneumatic servo. Okay, so the item duct, we need to set this right like that. Pneumatic servo. I guess I could use a lever. We're just doing this for simplicity. Ignore it. Okay, so anything I put in this chest will go into the pressure chamber. So let's do all of these things. So the little door opens and throws the items in. Oh, yeah. So how much pressure? Oh, we only needed 1 bar of pressure, and we should have more than that in the system right now. Yeah, we're up to like 4 bar. Okay, so another thing while that's working is I've set up a little station over here. I made some spruce barrels around a 3x3 dirt patch, and we did end up getting some ancient spores, so I'll go ahead and place one there. That'll make mycelium. We can use a watering can to spread that out faster. If I can find my watering can, it's probably in this chest here somewhere. There it is. Yeah, applied energistics. I am very much ready for that right now. Okay, so let's go and water can this. It'll spread. Come on, little fellas. Get those corners going. Okay, so now that we have mycelium here, as soon as we put water in these barrels, they're going to start turning into witch water. When these turn into witch water, it'll have a chance of spawning mushrooms on the mycelium, so I'm going to want to probably collect those. I did make a hardened portable tank. I've converted our regular portable tank into a hardened one, and I filled it up full of water. Since we have all this cactus collecting over here, I've just made the clean water out of cactus. You can right-click a bottle onto this tank, and I'll put it into the tank, so that makes things a little bit easier. So I can go ahead and empty a bucket here. We'll just take water and start throwing it in these. These will start turning into witch water. There's mushroom. And go ahead and fill up the rest of these. Yeah, we want all of this stuff witch water. The more witch water we have, the more sand we can put in there, which means the more soul sand we can make, which is pretty cool. Yeah, it's kind of silly collecting these mushrooms. We can farm them. Like, we can make the giant mushrooms and chop them down and things like that. But I figured, you know, since we're getting these things for free, we might as well collect them while we're here, right? So how far... Oh, this is already done. That's already done. And these are just a few more over here ready to complete. All right, so now we got witch water made. Awesome. So I can pick that guy back up. Okay, let's go check on our etching acid. Should be done by now, I would imagine. Oh no, it's in there. It's good. Yeah, this thing is weird. I've been noticing that the item filter is kind of a silly thing. So I've just been putting filters in there for items that will never be in the system. That way, whatever I put in there will convert into whatever we need it to be. Yeah, we don't have to worry about it. Okay, so now we got etching acid. I imagine we just stick it in a hole right there. I assume we don't want to touch the stuff. It's probably going to be bad. So let's throw some of these things in there. I'm probably going to take these things apart and stop them from being stacked. Let's just go and throw them all in there. Okay, so that'll do its thing. So after a while, I'll just come through here, pick up the acid, grab them, and put the acid back. All right, so what else do we need to do? We need sand. That's what we need. To make soul sand. So let's grab some of this extra sand that we have. Yeah, I only used like 32, half a stack after all that stuff that we made. So we can put the sand in here and that makes soul sand. Perfect. All right, so now we're going to want to take this stuff and sieve this. What I really want is nether warts so we can start making potions so I can make more speed upgrades for the pneumatic craft stuff. Yeah, so we got 12 chances here. Let's see what we can get. Hopefully we'll get something good. I think we're always gonna get a few pieces of the nether quartz, which is pretty awesome too. That'll help us make... I guess that'll help us put damage on our weapons. I think there's a few items we need the nether quartz for besides that though. Looks like we've only gotten nether quartz so far though, which is kind of disappointing. It's kind of hoping that we'd get nether wart. Well, I might have to do this a few times then. Yeah, it looks like just quartz so far. Only quartz. Dang, 18 quartz from 12 of them, which I guess isn't too terrible. Yeah, so that's got 5 minutes before it's going to despawn. So we got some time over here. I did make this 3x3 area of water to plant the squid seeds on, just trying that out. Yeah, that stuff is kind of difficult to work with, the squid seeds. I don't know, it seems like if you water can them, they randomly pop out of the water. I was going to say out of the ground. Yeah, they randomly pop out of the water, and I don't know, it's just kind of like a pain to make them work. Okay, so I'm just going to go and fill this up. I'm going to make some more witch water. I'm going to wait for those things to finish etching. I'm going to keep my eye on them so they don't despawn, because that would suck. But yeah, guys, let me go ahead and do some more things around here, and we'll be right back. Alright guys, so over the course of this episode, we've done quite a lot of things that's required some off-camera stuff. So I made a whole bunch of that soul sand. I think we had to do that, I think, 4 times. I went through quite a lot of our cactus, well, at least our reserve cactus. Last time I checked, we were just over a stack in this barrel over here. Looks like we might be up to 2 stacks. Yeah, 2 stacks plus 6. So I've also found out you can right-click the bottles directly, the water bottles under these barrels. You don't have to put it into a tank and then bucket it out. Yeah, just right-clicking the fresh water bottles onto these fills us up full of water, which is pretty cool. But yeah, like I said, we did that like 4 or 5 times worth of soul sand. We finally got nether wart, so I've been growing it over here. You can grow these using the watering can to speed it up, which I have been doing. So yeah, we've been collecting a little bit of this stuff. This will allow us to create potions. We need speed potions for those pneumatic craft speed upgrades. So yeah, that's kind of the whole purpose of me wanting this stuff. So we've gone through all of our gravel. I've smashed 2 stacks of it into sand. That's the sand that we got left. The rest of it has been pulverized by our machine over here during this entire episode. Well, I guess not all of it, because these all have their own inventory too. But yeah, this is the stuff we've collected so far. We got 6 more diamonds, 3 more emeralds, a lot of iron that needs to be smashed into smaller bits. Yeah, there's our fifth stack that's starting right here. So yeah, that's pretty cool. We also got 2 crushed ardite ore, which isn't very much, but I assume this is the only way we're going to be able to get the ardite and cobalt is through that soul sand. So I imagine we're going to be doing a lot more of that stuff in the future. We did get our 10 unassembled PCBs from the acid. So yep, that's pretty cool. So let's also take a look at our book and see what else we have to do. So unassemble, last step. Oh, last step is done. All right, well, last step is done. I must have counted when I made these previously or something. This says you will need transistors and capacitors for the step 3 of each. Recipes are in NEI. Yep, we've already done that before. Then it is a simple matter of combining those with the unassembled PCB, and then you are done. Don't worry, there is a better way to do this that will be covered later. I hope so, because this is kind of a pain. So let's see, that's going to give us a reward of 1 printed circuit board and 4 plastic sheets. Awesome. Okay, so that unlocks some other stuff over here. We still have this blueprint for success, and this wants us to submit a compressed iron, etching acid, emerald, and plastic for a bucket and a PCB blueprint. Why would we ever want to get that PCB blueprint? To make another light box? I don't know. It says this is a repeatable quest. I don't understand why we would ever want to do this. Just for a PCB blueprint. The only thing you can use those for is this UV light box, right? Let's check it out. This blueprint, what is this used for? Yeah, the only thing it's used for is the light box. Well, I guess if we ever wanted to make another light box? I don't know. Okay, so what else do we have here? Upgraded. This wants us to make machine upgrade speed, machine upgrade life, or item life, and security. Tools of the trade, a GPS tool. Interesting. Wait. Oh, look at that. We've already gotten the wrench. We got that from one of the cities, and a GPS tool, charging station. Okay, so we've already done 2 out of 3 of these. I see. So we have to make a GPS tool. And assembling circuit boards. So we need an assembly laser and an assembly controller. Can we make those? Assembly laser requires 3 of these, some of those, and red rose. I don't think we have any red rose. Is there a way we can make those? Fire flower seeds turn into that, but we don't have any fire flower seeds. Can we make fire flower seeds? Grass seeds plus rose red. Well, that's kind of interesting. I'm not sure how we're going to get the rose red. We'll probably find that in a city in one of those randomized chests, I would imagine. Yeah, I don't really know what else, because there aren't any flowers around. Oh, you know what? We have grass seeds. If we plant grass seeds on dirt, we can bone meal the grass, and I think we'll get flowers that way. That's probably how it's supposed to be done. All right, guys. Well, I tell you what, we're running long in this episode. I've been rambling a lot, but we got a lot of great stuff done. Resources won't be an issue for much longer. We're getting plenty of this stuff. I really need to reset up a thing to make this gravel automatically. I'll probably do that off camera since we've already done that before in the series. Yeah, so we got a lot of good stuff done. Got to wait for more cactus to collect. I'm curious, though, before we end it for good, how many ender pearls do we have over here that have been collected for us? So we've got almost a stack. Oh, that's awesome. All right, guys. That's going to do it for today. Thank you guys for watching. Remember to leave a like on this episode if you liked it. And we'll see you next time.